गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो दिस इज अवर चैप्टर नंबर 2, द नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन्स. सो टूडे वी विल डू द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच माउंटेन रेंजेस फॉर्म द नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन्स. विच माउंटेन रेंजेस फॉर्म द नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन्स. सो द आंसर इज द हिमालयाज, काराकोरम एंड पूर्वांचल हिल रेंजेस फॉर्म द नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन्स. सो दीज आर द 3 माउंटेन रेंजेस दैट फॉर्म द नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन्स. हिमालयाज दैट इज इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट, काराकोरम इट इज इन द नॉर्थ वेस्ट ऑफ द हिमालयाज एंड पूर्वांचल हिल रेंजेस. दीज रेंजेस आर इन द ईस्टर्न साइड. सो दीज 3 रेंजेस कंसिस्ट नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन्स. Now we have already studied that the Himalaya ranges, they are divided into 3 parallel ranges. The Greater Himalaya, Himadri, the Middle Himalaya, Himachal and the Outer Himalaya, Shivalik. Mount Everest is the highest peak of this mountain range Himalayas. Second is Karakoram. This Karakoram is in the northwest of the Himalayas. K2 and Mount Godwin-Aston is the second highest peak on this range. And these are the Purvanchal Hill ranges. These ranges covered with thick forest and a rich variety of wildlife. Now the next question. Describe the climate of the northern mountains. Then what is the climate of the northern mountains? We have studied that the climate of the northern mountains affect the climate of the whole country. Even the northern mountain affect the climate of the whole country. These northern mountains create a barrier to the northern side so that the winds that blown from the Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea cannot blow away from the India. Or cannot grow from outside the India. So they create heavy rainfall in the northern plain. So the climate of the northern mountain is, it has a cold desert climate. The northern mountains, the highest mountain peaks that are in the Himalayas always covered with the snow. So it has a cold desert climate. It is a barren, arid and frigid region. Barren region, arid region and frozen region. Which region? The Himalaya region. That is a cold desert. The southern areas of Himalayas are largely protected from cold winter winds coming from the interior of Asia. The Himalaya range, it is a barrier that protect us from cold winter winds that coming from the interior of the Asia. So they create a barrier to us so that there is not too much cold in our country. Now the Himalaya ranges. Here we have studied about that the Himalaya ranges largely protect from cold winter winds. In our chapter, we have studied about the climate of the northern mountains. That is the Himalaya mountains that are cold desert climate. After that, in the Himachal range, the middle Himalaya, in the Himachal range, there is the pleasant climate. The summers are around 17 degrees Celsius. And after that, the outer Himalaya, that is not too much cold like the middle Himalaya or like the greater Himalaya, but receive heavy rainfall. But here, we have not written the climate. Or I have not written the climate of all the 3 different ranges. We have written the overall climate of northern mountain. Next, the third question. Why is a pass an important part of a range? A mountain pass. Why a mountain pass is an important part of a mountain range? How does it help humans? So the answer is, pass is an important part of a range because it provides the easiest routes to travel across mountain range. We have studied about the mountain pass, that it is a route in the mountain range by which people can easily travel across mountain ranges. So passes plays a very important role in the mountain range because without passes it become difficult for the people to travel across mountain range. So these passes provide the easiest routes to travel across the mountain range. Now how does it help humans? That how the mountain passes help the human beings? It help humans in migration, trade and settlement. It help humans in migration. Migration means the movement of people from one place to another place. Trade for business and settlement for settlement. Now these passes help the human beings in migration. By using these passes, people are going from one place to another place by using this mountain range, or they are travel across mountain range using these passes. Trade or business. For trade, for business, people are going to one place to another place or from one country to another country. By using these passes, people, for example, there are the some tribes living in the Himalaya mountains. Mostly these tribes use these passes for their settlement. They across through these passes, they travel across mountain range. So it is very helpful for those peoples, those who are the tribes, and migration, trade and settlement. Now the next question, how do the northern mountains cause rainfall in our country? Due to their height, width and direction, these mountains intercept the summer monsoon winds coming from Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea and cause rainfall in our country. Due to the height of the northern mountains, width and direction of these mountains intercept the summer monsoon winds coming from Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea. So these mountains create a barrier so that the winds coming from the Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea cannot blow outside the country, and these winds create or cause heavy rainfall in our country. These winds cause heavy rainfall in our country. So the northern mountains are very important or play a very important role in the cause of rainfall in our country. The next question, why are there so many natural parks and wildlife sanctuaries in the northern mountains? So as you know that the Shivalik range of the northern mountains is covered with thick forest and has a wide variety of wild animals. So there are so many natural parks and wildlife sanctuaries on this range. It is so because to protect our wildlife from illegal hunting and various risks of endangered species. So why there are so many natural parks and wildlife sanctuaries? Because better to give protection to our wildlife from illegal hunting. And various risks of endangered species. Now what is the meaning of endangered species? Endangered species are the species which are at the risk of extinction. And why they are on the risk of extinction? Just because of decrease in their population or loss in their habitation. Loss in their habitation, how? That today people are cutting forest. So it is a big loss for the wildlife and illegal hunting. So now our government has banned on the illegal hunting, but earlier days it was common illegal hunting. So that's why our government has established so many wildlife sanctuaries and natural parks to give protection to our wildlife from illegal hunting and various risk of endangered species. Next, define valley, terai, glacier and pass. So first, valley. Now what is a valley? A low-lying area between two hills or mountains. A low-lying area between two hills or mountains is known as valley. There are so many valleys in our northern mountains, Kangra and Nainital, the famous valleys. Next, terai. The foothills of the Himalayas are called terai. So the foothills of the Himalaya are called terai. And this is common in the Shivalik range. Glacier, a slow moving area of ice. Sorry, a slow moving river of ice. So the glacier is a slow moving river of ice. We have glaciers like Gangotri, Yamunotri. The river originates from these glaciers and they flow throughout the year. Next, pass. A route through a mountain range is called a pass. So just now we have studied about pass, that a mountain pass is a route through a mountain range by which people travel across the mountain range. Hello students, so now let's revise the first chapter, India, Our Country. So there are some important terms of the chapter first. India is the seventh largest country in terms of area and second largest country in terms of population. So our country India, it holds seventh position in terms of area in the world and it holds second position in world in terms of population. The first country that holds the first position in population, that is China. India is divided in 28 states and 9 union territories. So now we have 28 states. Now Jammu and Kashmir is no more a state. So we have 28 states and 9 union territories. The two newly formed union territories are Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. India is divided into 6 major physical divisions. So our country India, that is divided into 6 major physical divisions. And these physical divisions makes our country a beautiful country, like mountains, plateaus, northern plains, desert. All these major physical divisions make our country a beautiful country that attracts the tourists from all around the world. So now let's discuss about all the 6 major physical divisions that are, first, the northern mountains, then the northern plains, the Great Indian Desert or the Thar Desert, the southern plateau, the coastal plains and the islands. Next, India shares its boundary with Afghanistan, Pakistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh. So in the northwest direction we have Afghanistan and Pakistan as a neighboring country. China, Nepal, Bhutan are in the northern side. In the east we have Myanmar and Bangladesh and in the south we have Sri Lanka. Largest state of India is Rajasthan. Now the largest state and smallest state we will discuss. So In terms of area, Rajasthan is the largest state and Goa is the smallest state. India has a long coastline of 7,516 kilometers. So this is the coastline of India, 7,516 kilometers, including Lakshadweep Island and Andaman and Nicobar Island. So India has a long coastline, that is 7,516 kilometers. India is surrounded by three water bodies. So our country India, it is surrounding by three water bodies: Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, and Indian Ocean. So these three water bodies that surrounds India, it also makes our country a peninsula. The meaning of peninsula is a land area or a region that is surrounded by water from three sides. So our country India is surrounded by these three water bodies. So our country is also known as Peninsula India. The southern part of our country is also known as Peninsula India. Yes, beta. So after question answers, revise these important terms of chapter number 1. Because on Tuesday there will be the weekly test of SST and science, and in that your homework will be chapter number 1, India, our country, and chapter 2, the northern mountains. So revise both the chapters properly. Thank you.